Hello and welcome. Thank you so much for joining us for our special screening of My Name is Pauli Murray. I am so excited to be here with the co-directors of the piece. Thank you, Betsy and Julie, for joining us and for sharing your work with us at Damley's Heels. We are elated to have you with us.
Thank you, Ash.
It's a real pleasure. It's a real pleasure. So I'm just going to get started asking you a few questions about this amazing work. I'll start by just really inquiring about the impetus for this project. You know, Pauli Murray, of course, is such an important figure, but is so underserved in terms of how we've come to know the story of such an incredible body of work. How did you discover this figurehead, and what felt important for you to make this incredible document?
You want to go ahead, Julie?
Sure.
You take it first this time.
Okay. You know, we learned about Pauli Murray through Ruth Bader Ginsburg, about whom we'd made the documentary RBG in 2018. RBG let us know briefly that Pauli had gotten a name check in the very first brief that RBG wrote for the US Supreme Court arguing for gender equality under law. She listed Pauli Murray as a co-author, even though Pauli hadn't been involved in that particular case, but just wanting to give a very notable nod to the important ideas that Pauli had developed on the question of going for full gender equality under the 14th Amendment of the US Constitution. We learned that, we sort of filed that fact aside, like, huh, who's this Pauli Murray person? Like, don't really know that name. And then later on, we sort of did a little bit of research and learned that, like, what Pauli contributed to women's equality was really just the tip of the iceberg on this body of work that was so mind-blowingly big and varied and in so many different fields that you're kind of like, whoa, how come we don't know more about this person? How come we didn't learn more about this person? And shouldn't everybody know more about the history of Pauli Murray?
The answer is yes. And we're glad to be a part of this incredible intervention, yeah, in the history. I'm curious, you know, beyond, of course, this instance that brought you into the idea and world of Pauli in general, how you feel that RBG's work speaks to Pauli's and vice versa. Of course, that was the last wonderful film we were able to see of yours, and they seem in conversation to me. What resonated across the two projects for you as you're making it and as you're, you know, presenting it as well?
Yeah, I mean, as Julie said, RBG as a litigator really wanted to give Pauli credit and for coming up with what at the time was a very radical idea, which is that the 14th Amendment could help win equality for American women. And also RBG knew Pauli because they had both sat on the board of the ACLU. And so, you know, constitutional rights were important to both of them. And when we came up with this idea, you know, one of the first things we had to do was to figure out, could we tell a story about someone who's been dead for over three decades? And, you know, luckily, Pauli left a phenomenal archive that we can maybe talk about a little later. But not only that, there were people who knew Pauli, including RBG. So one of the first things we did was to write an email to Justice Ginsburg and say that we were going to do this documentary and would she give us an interview? And she immediately wrote back, "That's a marvelous idea," and said yes, and scheduled an interview. So we did that really as the first thing, because it was very important for us to find these touchstones for Pauli's accomplishments. And certainly in the area of legal strategy and thinking about feminism, the line from Pauli to RBG is a very straight line. And then we had to find the other connections for all the other accomplishments that Pauli made.
Absolutely, it's so clear and it's so wonderful to see that legacy play out on screen. And yes, let's talk about the archive. It's so rich, it's so amazing. talk us through a little bit of what the post process was like, sorting through so much material, and also in general, your films strike me as, you know, academic in such a serious way. How do you layer these things all together? And I feel like it ends up being a very personal portrait. But you obviously take seriously, very seriously, the challenge of, you know, bringing these legalities, these on paper issues to life. How did you approach that technically?
Yeah, well, first of all, our philosophical approach was we wanted to come as close as we could to creating what felt like an autobiographical documentary. To the extent possible, we wanted the viewer to feel like they were hearing Pauli's story in Pauli's own words. That was only possible because Pauli made it possible by saving all this stuff. Not only every single draft ever written of every legal brief or every law school paper, but also really personal diaries and journals and this incredible amount of audio tape. Pauli was interviewed by a number of both journalists and historians doing oral history. And every time someone would come to Pauli's house to do an interview, Pauli would get out a tape recorder and press play and create a double that would then go into this archive. So, you know, it really wasn't the post process adding the archival stuff. That was really more the beginning. We really started with Pauli's words and then figured out what else do we need to fill out the story? Who are the other characters who are going to walk us through the moments and kind of elevate points of the story where you hear Pauli describing it, but maybe you'd like to, you know, some firsthand account of what it was really felt like to be there, or someone who discovered Pauli later and what that felt like to sort of bring it into a contemporary thing. So the archive was really the heart and soul of everything, and everything else fit into that major important foundation.
Yeah, and I would add that, yes, this was a serious academic endeavor in terms of researching Pauli's work, but we also wanted it to be a personal documentary, as Julie said, to feel like it was coming from Pauli Murray and to really experience Pauli as much as possible, as much as you could, what it was like to live the extraordinary life that Pauli lived, the ups and the downs, the challenges, and certainly her Pauli's personal life. We wanted to not only highlight the achievements, the professional achievements, but, you know, the larger picture of who this extraordinary person was.
Absolutely. And it feels so well-rounded and so full. And yes, like you said, you can feel that it's really guided by the person that it's about. And I think that's why it connects so deeply with people and definitely with my team, of course. And I'm curious to hear a little bit about how you approached faith in obviously in this work. And I think it even touched on RBG as well. It's an important part of our community in Salt Lake, and it's an important part of your film. What was that process like, and how did you try to render that bit of Pauli's experience as a clergy person?
Yeah, I think, you know, there were so many elements to Pauli's life that were challenging to connect to. I mean, the interesting thing about the faith part was that even Pauli's closest friends and family, many of them couldn't quite get a handle on, you know, whoa, the seminary, that is so major. But like, faith was so important, and it felt like such a big moment towards the end of the film, when Pauli is ordained as a minister and as an Episcopal priest, and you're seeing, you know, a sermon and greeting of parishioners in this really lovely service, and it happens to be color footage where we've had mostly black and white, so it feels like this moment of sort of joy and opening up. So I think we literally even had that scene completed and edited before we sort of tried to, we realized like, oh, it's kind of feeling like the religion thing is just coming in from out of the blue, which was not true in Pauli's life. So how can we sort of salt it in throughout the film to give you, like, to kind of lead you to that moment?
Yeah. And, you know, Pauli's relationship with Rini was built on their connection as practicing Episcopalians. Yeah. And, you know, we used one of Pauli's poems that Pauli deliberately set in a liturgical, you know, prayer structure. So, and obviously as a little girl, Pauli was going to church, putting on that dress, despite every, you know, despite Aunt Paul, you know, the rest of the week, the pants, but Sunday dress and going off to church. So we, as Julie said, we didn't want it to just come out of the blue, even though for some of Pauli's friends and colleagues, it really did shock them. But clearly, you know, the Pauli's comment about how at this stage of life, I think Pauli felt that the law could only go so far in terms of fulfilling Pauli as a human being. And we tried to convey through Karen Rouse Ross, Pauli's grandniece, the sense of how Pauli evolved as a person and the peace and the acceptance that Pauli found in ministering to people in the church, you know, she was always a talker, became a listener. That was another evolution that Karen helped us explain.
It's beautiful. And I think, of course, Pauli is a great role model in so many rights, but showing this, the coexistence of queerness and of faith so beautifully is really special and not so easily done. It's obviously a very complicated thing. I'm curious to hear, we've seen in our program this year a sort of tenet of unearthing history, of revisiting a history, of looking back and bringing up queer history that we haven't seen before. And I'm curious, in terms of your careers, it seems like you have, you know, obviously a specific bent, a specific interest in this. What do you think is the power of documentary to correct some of these things, and what do you hope to do with this film and with your work in general on that front?
Yeah, I think there's a real, you know, there are some wrongs to be righted. I mean, certainly working on this film made us think a lot about our own, what was missing from our own educations. And not just about Pauli Murray, by the way, about a lot of the contexts that shaped Pauli's life that aren't events that weren't necessarily familiar to people who did. You know, I paid attention in school, but like, you know, there was just like a lot that wasn't there. And the joy now being documentary filmmakers is it really is kind of an opportunity to revisit some of the history that we were all as a society haven't grappled with enough. And certainly that includes African American history, and very much it includes queer history. And I think there's a general public right now that's more open and more kind of thirsty and curious for more of this, to learn more of this stuff. So it just feels like a fun role to play to help try to find it. I mean, we're not historians, we're not academics. Fortunately, academics have known about Pauli Murray for a long time, but like to bring it into a more popular mode is fun as a documentary filmmaker.
Yeah, I mean, I think Julie just used the word opportunity. It really is an opportunity because there are all these untold stories. And I think for us telling the RBG story, I really didn't know until about 2010, the role that Ruth Bader Ginsburg as a litigator had played in Equal Rights for Women. I had no idea. I lived through the women's movement, you know, it really is my generation. I knew about Gloria Steinem, didn't know about RBG. Similarly, I worked on a film as an executive producer, Lavender Scare, which, you know, about the persecution, the official government-sponsored persecution of LGBTQ individuals carried out for decades by the US government. When the director, Josh Howard, read the Lavender Scare book and called me and told me about this, I'm like, what? You know, it amazed me. So it is an opportunity to right wrongs and as a filmmaker to tell extraordinary stories.
And I think I speak for many that we're all indebted and grateful to the work you two are doing to bring light to some of these things. And I'll say, as we have to wrap up and we're out of time, I'm so grateful to be able to play this, especially in Utah, where we are still seeing so many, you know, legal battles sort of playing out in the legislature and more work to do on these very fronts. We're just so glad to have this legacy be part of our programming this year, and hopefully give us a look back so that we can see a way forward to do the rest of the work that needs doing. So thank you for sharing the film. Thank you for showing us Pauli's wonderful and incredible life. And thank you for talking with us today. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Thanks so much, Josh.